Hi all, Carrie here from Urbanite Farms in the bean jungle. Thought y'all might want to see a little bit of the garden today. This is what I've harvested so far. Full basket of beans and tomatoes. And as you can see, these bean plants are going crazy. We are definitely going to have to arch trellis these next year so that I'm not down on my knees picking. We've also got some red runner beans that I've been trying to grow all season that finally decided to start producing beans. I didn't realize they like the cool weather. So looks like we're gonna have a bumper crop of those this year too. These are a Asian long bean that I've had great success with. And I really, really like these a lot. I'm gonna be planting these again. This is another type of Asian long beans, but this is called Oriental Wonder. It's just a darker green. These over here are a much lighter green, but they pretty much taste the same and they grow just as well. So, the summer garden has really spent out, and it's beautiful, the stuff that's been here all year, such as the marigolds. But we've also started planting fall crops. So if you look along this way here, we have a whole bunch of stuff freshly planted since the end of August. The start of the garden here is kind of an experiment, which I'm not real happy with due to the tree that is overhanging here. It's sickly and it is dropping a lot of nastiness on top of my green area here, which I had planted spinach and Swiss chard and kale and some beets and some radishes, and they're not doing too well. I don't know if you can see this or not, but this gelatinous fungus type stuff that drops from the tree gets all down in here, and I don't think it's very good for the plants. So we're taking that tree out this year. But I did put up this new little trellis here for the peas. So we have some climbing peas all along here. They're starting to flower. So we should be getting peas pretty soon. And then in our covered row, this first covered row here, our final sunflower is blooming. That's the last one I planted. And then we have our brassicas and some bush beans planted here, a third round of beans. And the brassicas are getting attacked by worms and slugs and everything else right now, but so far I'm winning the battle. Hopefully we'll get something out of it. These particular brassicas are broccoli. So we've got a whole row of broccoli and a couple other ones splashed in here and there. And then these are the peppers that we planted early in the season that just didn't do anything, but boy, they sure are popping now. Those are some Marconis, and they get huge. That's about half the size they get. They're gonna get much bigger. And then we have some banana peppers. Oh, I'm sorry, purple bell. These are purple bell. And then the banana peppers. These are our Joe's plants. Joe planted these banana peppers. He really loves those. And then next to that, we have these shishito peppers, and they kind of look like ghost peppers. I've never grown them before, and my husband said that they're pretty spicy. They're supposed to be sweet, so I'm not sure if we got a wrong plant or if that's what they're...
Somebody...
switch tags?
Yeah, switch tags on you.
That's what I'm thinking. But hey, they'll get eaten either way. He said they're good, so... And if you continue down this way, we've got one variegated sweet pepper plant that I'm letting this one go because it said that you can let them turn orange or you can pick them just as they're green. But they come in like stripy hues. They're really a pretty pepper. I really like the plant a lot. I'm gonna save some seeds from this one. Then we have poblanos. We've got about 6 poblano plants. And these are a favorite in our house. We like to stuff them. We like to stir fry them. We like to
put them on the grill and then dehydrate them to make
ancho powder.
Ancho powder.
Yeah, they're really
eggs
good.
And things in the morning.
But we originally had 6 plants. I think we're down to 4. Like I said, the peppers didn't do too well at the beginning of the year. They struggled a lot because of the shaded area I planted them in. But we won't do that next year. Learned our lesson. And then the jalapenos. We've got some massive jalapenos down here. We're about to do a picking of these. Yep. Whole bunch of jalapenos.
Beans.
And this is the second round of beans that are producing right now that I'm picking. And these are just bush beans, like a Blue Lake bush bean. And then sporadically planted in the holes, we have kohlrabi and rutabagas and kale and some green onions here and there. And then we have cabbage. And then I transplanted a couple of pepper plants over here mid-season because it gets more sun, and they're just starting to produce. So good deal. Those are going to be good. And then these are some more scarlet runner beans that I planted as a second round since the first ones weren't producing, and they're just now getting ready. I'm gonna be picking these today. As you walk down this way, I've got a whole bunch of them. Some of them are doing better than others, but they're all starting to come up. Some of them are flowering now. Some of them will be flowering in the next month or so. And I threw in a couple of cucumber plants in different places to try and do a second round because the cucumber beetles took out my cucumber plants really early this year, and I didn't get a whole lot of cucumbers, and they seem to be doing okay. I actually have a few little cucumbers on here, so maybe we'll get cucumbers. And as you walk down this way, you will see rattlesnake beans. Ooh, that's a beauty there. That one's ready. Isn't that pretty? So this is new. We've never had these before, so we're gonna try these, and if we like them, we'll plant them again because they seem to really grow well. Here's another one. So we'll be picking those later today. This plant's really loaded. This was the very first plant that I planted. The first set of seeds I put down got taken out. Something dug them up, I think a raccoon or something. So this was the only one that survived that first planting. Looks like they're going to be pretty prolific.
More cabbage.
Then as you go down this row, this is cabbage.
Beans and then cabbage.
Yep, second row of beans. Everywhere that I had squash earlier in the season, I planted beans because the beans put nitrogen back into the soil where the squash took it out. So next year I'll be ready to put more squash or tomatoes or whatever in its place. So these are doing pretty good. Little issue with pests. I did put some diatomaceous earth on it a couple of weeks ago, and it's rained and taken it out. So the little worms are coming back. So I'm gonna need to do that again probably. I also spray BT on it. Do not ask me how to say that.
BT.
It's a very long name, but BT, everyone knows it by BT. And the BT doesn't hurt other bugs. It just hurts caterpillars because you spray it on the leaves, caterpillars eat the leaves, and then they die. But the diatomaceous earth can hurt other bugs, like good bugs, like bees. So I only do that if I absolutely have to. So we're going to go with BT, I think, first again, and try to get rid of the caterpillars with that. Then we're back over here where we started.
You got more beans and these are red.
Oh yeah, these are my red Asian beans. These were a happy accident. They came in the package marked as a Oriental Wonder, and they wound up being a purple. So I'm really happy with that. I'm saving some seeds from those as well. This was my Perilla bush that has flowered and is about ready to go to seed. I'm gonna be pulling that out here soon. I really just left it for the pollinators because the bees really love it. Smells really good. It is edible. Actually,
you can eat the leaves as a salad, and yeah, then the seeds are comparable to chai seeds.
Yeah.
Perilla seeds have a very high, I don't need to be on camera. You be okay.
Yeah, perilla seeds have a very high omega content. And the leaves, it actually smells like licorice. And Asians will use the leaves and they'll wrap things in them like kimchi and different stuff, and they'll make meals out of the leaves. I personally do not like the leaves, but they smell great. And like I said, the pollinators love it, so we keep it. And then we have in here coming up, these are rutabagas, which are kind of like a potato. You use them like a potato. And a second round of eggplant. I've actually already harvested one eggplant off of these, so I'm hoping to get some more before our first freeze. And this is my annual flower box that I plant my zinnias in, and different flowers that you need to replant every year. But this year I got some discounted plants at Lowe's on clearance for like a dollar. So I put a few of those in. We'll see if they come back next year. All kinds of zinnias are coming back up from seed though. If you see all these are all reseeded by themselves. So I might get some more flowers before the end of the season. And this box here is my perennial box. So this is full of all the things that come back every year. This mum was a tiny little thing like that big last year, and it's huge this year. So I'm really happy with that. My lilac bush is doing really well. It'll bloom again in the spring. And this was the bee balm that I showed y'all earlier in the year. It got huge. And this is our little friend Charlotte. Charlotte is the protector of the garden. This is Charlotte number two, actually. Charlotte number one already laid her egg sac for the season and has since vanished. So we got another little friend. And now we're into our tomatoes, although we skipped a row.
Well, let me go back down that one.
This is the rest of the cabbage. Because my husband mentioned to me that
I love cabbage.
He loves cabbage, and that wasn't enough cabbage. So I bought another pack of cabbage and put some more cabbage in. And as you go down the row,
this is the other side of the beans.
Right, this is the other side of the trellis.
Who wants beans?
Huh?
I said, who wants more beans?
Really, who needs beans?
We've got freezers full.
And in the middle of the beans, I planted Malabar spinach. I don't know if y'all have ever had Malabar spinach before, but it's a spinach that grows in the heat. And it has that like gelatinous, has that gelatinous stuff like okra does in the middle of it. So if you eat it raw, it's, I mean, it's okay. It's kind of like dirt tasting, really.
No, it's
honestly
not dirt. I don't think it is.
You don't think so? Mm-mm. Okay. Well, I guess it depends on your palate.
It has a chewy.
Yeah, it's
kind of a. I don't know, creamy kind of a taste.
Creamy kind of taste. Well, if you cook it, it tastes just like spinach. So
what
it's
is
one
spinach?
Of the,
it's Malabar spinach.
So it's one of the few greens that you can grow in the heat of the summer. As you can see, it grows fantastically in the summer. And then it produces these little berries that you can use as a food dye. These will turn the same color as this, kind of a purplish color. This is a purple Malabar and this is a green, but all of the little berries will turn purple. And in the olden days, they used to use it to dye cloth and dye different things, but you can use it as a food dye. If you want to make like a red velvet cake, you can use that to dye it so that you're not using the fake food coloring. So. And then I have down here some
garden cats.
Yeah, garden cats. And my purple beans, which
the deer have gotten.
The deer have eaten the tops off of all of them. But these are, hi baby, my little garden guardian. These are the purple beans. They're really pretty. The only thing is when you cook them, they turn green. So, you know, they taste just like green beans. And then as you work your way down, you come back into more Asian beans on the left and tomatoes on the right. My tomato plants have been kind of behind this year because I got them in late, but my bigger tomatoes are starting to produce. I've got lots of big tomatoes on the vine. Walk around and I'll show you. And this set of four plants here, these were my determinant tomatoes. They're sauce tomatoes. They're called Napoli. They did not do well at all. I don't know.
Basil.
I don't know what the issue was with those, but they just, they did not do well. And I'm getting a few here and there, but they're just not really big. So I ordered a different kind of tomato. I did some research and I ordered a sauce tomato called Big Mama.
And Big Mama.
They're kind of teardrop shaped tomatoes, about this big, and they're for sauce. And the difference between a sauce tomato and your regular like beefsteak tomatoes or slicers is that they don't have all that juicy pulp in the middle. So after you peel them and put them in a pot to make sauce with them, you don't have to boil it down for hours and hours and hours. It doesn't take as long because there's not as much juice. So that's why I wanted to try and do the sauce tomatoes, but these were an epic failure. So next year. And as you go down the middle of the row of the tomatoes, we have some more. I believe these are rutabagas. Yeah, rutabagas. I didn't plant any potatoes this year, so I'm trying rutabagas instead. They're kind of a hit or miss. I had something in here digging up my plants and seeds, so I think raccoons. And I just went through and picked all my cherry tomatoes, so there's not a whole lot ripe on the vine right now, but those are a blueberry cherry, and they have been very horrific this year. Ooh, look at this beauty. This is a really pretty tomato that comes off this plant. It's a yellow tomato and it's variegated. It has the stripes in it and it's really good. It's a really good meaty slicer. It was called Lunch Lovers. Those are Lunch Lover tomatoes. More basil. I interplant the basil with my tomato plants because number one, it makes the tomatoes taste better. And number two, it's a pest deterrent. It helps deter pests like caterpillars and the white flies and different things like that that like to get on your tomatoes. And here's another one of those cucumber plants I was talking about that I kind of intermixed in as plants died out. And this one actually looks great. There's a cucumber on the back side right there. So I think I will get at least a few cucumbers this fall. Now this whole row, I tried to plant nasturtiums about the middle of the summer. This is the only guy that survived. I'm waiting for him to flower. That's a good flower to plant in your garden as well because it's all edible. The flowers are edible, the leaves are edible. They kind of taste like pepper. So you can chop them up and put them in your salad. Hopefully I can get some more of those to grow next year. They're a little finicky.
So what percentage of everything you plant is edible?
Well, the only thing that I plant that's not edible is probably this box here.
That's just your flower box, perennials.
Yeah, and this box, the other box over here, most of this is edible as well.
Flowers.
Flower-wise, yeah. But pretty much just the flowers are the only thing that's not edible. And this is okra. This poor guy has been attacked by those harlequin beetles and stink beetles, and it's been eating the leaves. That is a okra I'm letting go to seed. So
gather seeds and plant it next year.
Yep, we'll gather seeds from that and plant it next year. So what I do is instead of purposefully saving one for seeds, I wait until I miss one and it gets too big because inevitably that always happens. And so that's one that I missed that I'm just letting go to seed. And these are, I'm not sure what kind of plants. I mean, I know they're okra, but I'm not sure what variety because I got a seed packet this past year that was just a mix of different types of okra. And these last two plants, I really, really like. They have this skinny little okra that's not very spindly and you can let it get kind of big and it stays thin. So as you chop it up for frying or for whatever you want to do, there's not a lot of that gelatinous mucusy stuff.
And you gotta pull it down because they grow so high.
Yeah, they grow so high I can't reach to pick. So I found this little trick. I think it was on YouTube, where you just tie a string to it and put it on a brick, and at first, see how this one is standing up? That's for that second plant. And then as it gets too tall again, then you flip the brick and it comes down again, because they will continue to grow up. So, and then as this one gets too tall to pick, I'll just tie the string down a little further to bring it down. So that's worked so far. I have to do these plants next. These ones are just now starting to get up. Here's another one I'm saving for seeds, one of the red variety. That one's really big. You just let them go until they dry out and turn hard. So.
Flowers that turn into fried okra.
That's it. And then behind you, I have a second sowing of carrots. And my sweet little knockout rose bush. And then this is all mint. We've already cut it back once. And it's coming up again. This mint, man. Make sure if you plant mint in your garden, you put it somewhere where it's contained, because it will take over. Every year we cut it all the way back and it just keeps coming back.
So what's new for the garden, Carrie?
Well, let me tell you what's new for the garden. We are creating two new garden boxes.
What? Say it ain't so.
Yeah. My wonderful husband, came down here and used our brand new tiller, new to us anyway. That's Henry the workhorse. And he tilled all of this up so that we can get these brand new boxes in this week. And we've got it all measured out. We just got to get the screw gun and the screws down here and put it together and fill them up.
Somebody's got to get a wheelbarrow and start shoveling dirt. Hey, kids!
Really?
Kids!
And we're going to be filling these full of garlic. So we'll have lots of
over
garlic.
Over winter planning.
Over winter planning.
Which is going to be your garlic, onions.
Yep, I've already got onions in here at either end where you see the straw. These are onions. I started seeds
at this
end.
Horseradish at the end down there.
Yep. I started onion seeds at this end, which you can see there are already little onions coming up here. And then in the middle is my failed attempt at beets. There's a few of them. And then where the other straw is, those are onion sets that I just planted in. And at the very end is horseradish, which we're going to be harvesting probably in another month or so. So, starting to get ready.
We didn't go down that aisle, but that's just more tomatoes on each side. And what's down the center?
Down the center is basil and some baby okra plants.
Baby okra.
Yep, that's a little experiment. I'm trying to see if they are as prolific.
And you got more eggplant down at this end and mixed in with the beans over here as well as the box.
Yeah, I didn't show you the eggplant mixed in with the beans because the beans and the Malabar spinach have pretty much taken them over. They're still producing. You just can't really see them. They're just kind of buried in there. And at the very end of these two rows, I have collard greens, because you cannot plant collard greens with your other brassicas for whatever reason. So I don't know the reasoning, actually. I just have read it several times, so I kept them separate. So they're over here. And lots of basil. Lots of basil down that middle row.
So going into the first week of October here, October 4th, 5th, something like that today.
Yeah.
Garden's doing well. Looks like we're going to get a couple more months and then do the fall season.
Mm-hmm.
The winter season, excuse me, the winter planting. And get ready for spring.
That's right. So, great talking with y'all. Have a blessed day.